This private hospital in Quezon City has allocated 15 beds for COVID-19 patients. While they don't have a lot of patients compared to bigger health facilities, their health workers face the same challenges, such as overcapacity and overworked personnel. In fact, their emergency room has patients waiting for a vacant bed just to be admitted.
On a daily basis, there is this particular lineup, averaging around 2 to 3 patients per day, awaiting to be admitted because that necessitates admission. So in other words, we are already in our full capacity when it comes to admissions, both in the critical units as well as that in the ward units.
Dr. Agudon also says it's critical the public also understands the importance of strictly adhering to health protocols, since additional cases will ultimately put a burden on the health system.
Aside from the variants, I'm more concerned about the availability of a healthcare facility that will be able to cater to the COVID-19 affected population. Because we do have that limited also outlets, limited healthcare delivery systems.
Smaller hospitals and bigger health facilities are straining under the weight of surging infections. The Philippine General Hospital, a COVID referral facility, is currently caring for 156 COVID patients.
Sometimes patients do come in and they're really unstable and we need to tie them over in the emergency room.
Yeah.
So sometimes our emergency room will look like a war zone with intubated patients. Konting tulong po sa amin. Napapagod din po kami. Hopefully, malakpasan natin to.
At the East Avenue Medical Center, occupancy rate of COVID-19 beds is now at 77%. And to make matters worse, some of its staff have contracted the virus. As of March 14, more than 15,000 health workers have been infected by the coronavirus. Fortunately, most of them have recovered. Despite the dire situation, the Healthcare Professionals Alliance Against COVID-19 still doesn't see the need to ask for a timeout from government or the implementation of strict lockdown measures, which include curbs on mobility.
We have to be honest. Things have not really changed much since we called for a timeout in August. And we have to be humble enough to admit that we all have failed in so many aspects in terms of our preventive measures at both personal and institutional levels.
This time around, they are calling on business leaders and the public to do more.
For business and industry leaders, request po sana namin kung pwede po nating ma-decongest muna ang ating mga workplace. Bawasan po muna natin ang mga pumapasok if we can implement staggered work hours para hindi po sabay-sabay ang pasok ng mga trabahador. Pwede rin po sana paki-improve ang ventilation sa ating mga trabahuan. Malaking tulong po ito para mapigilan ang pagkalat ng COVID in the workplace.
The group is also appealing to local governments to allow more access to open spaces and discourage the public from eating in areas without proper ventilation.
Let's stop blaming the people. They're doing everything they can to comply. Kaya lang, we force them into crowds to help the people comply. Kasi pagod na sila eh, na trying to comply. And they are forced into, kita mo naman eh, napipilitang pumila ng siksikan, sumakay sa siksikan.
Dr. Dance says, occupancy rates in COVID referral hospitals is now at the critical level. While in Metro Manila, occupancy rate of ICU beds is at 50%. The group points out, they will not hesitate to call for a timeout if needed. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.